Hello everyone, good morning students. Dear students, in previous class we take and discuss a very important chapter of your syllabus, which is surface area and volumes. And in that class we discuss all the important formula related to each and every shape of solid which are involved in that chapter. And we also take and solve some important question based on these shapes of solids like sphere, cone, cylinder, etc. Now dear friends, in today's class we also take and solve some important questions of your NCERT exercise based on these shapes of solid which are involved in your chapter. Okay, now dear friends, we take and solve some important question of your NCERT exercise based on surface area and volume. Let's see. And your question is, a right circular cylinder just encloses a sphere of radius r as shown in figure, find the first part of this question, surface area of the sphere. Second one is what? Chord surface area of the cylinder. And third one is what? Ratio of the areas obtained in 1 and 2. Okay, and your figure is, let's see. Sphere. First of all, we draw a right circular cylinder. Look. And a sphere encloses in it. A sphere encloses in it. Okay, in this way. And dear friends, here this is our, and this is the figure. Okay, this is the figure which is given in our question, dear friend. And our question is, let's see once more time. Here our right circular cone cylinder, here our right circular cylinder is given, okay, and just encloses a sphere of radius r. Surely we find the surface area of the sphere. Now dear sir, in that figure it is clear that this is r, this is also equal to r. So let's see its solution. From figure it is clear that the base radius of the cylinder is r, and its vertical height is what? 2r, na? Because of this is r. So whole height is what? 2r. So dear sir, in this way, from it is clear that the base radius of the cylinder is r, and
its height be r plus r, that is 2r respectively. Two r is the height of the
cylinder. Height of the cylinder. Okay, now first of all we take and solve the first part of this question. Surface area of the sphere. Dear student, you know that the formula of the surface area of a sphere is what? कि सरफेस एरिया ऑफ स्फेयर इज ओनली डिपेंड्स ओनली इट्स रेडियस. तो फर्स्ट पार्ट इज व्हाट? सरफेस एरिया ऑफ स्फेयर इज व्हाट? 4πr² और रेडियस इज आर, तो 4πr² दिस इज द सरफेस एरिया ऑफ द स्फेयर. सेकेंड वन इज व्हाट? सेकेंड वन इज कर्व्ड सरफेस एरिया ऑफ. डियर फ्रेंड, कर्व्ड सरफेस एरिया ऑफ सिलेंडर इज 2πr into h. नाउ आर इज व्हाट? द रेडियस ऑफ बेस रेडियस ऑफ द सिलेंडर एंड द हेयर इन दैट क्वेश्चन द बेस रेडियस ऑफ द सिलेंडर इज आर ओनली, तो इट इज राइट एज आर. एंड द हाइट इज व्हाट? 2r. तो हेयर वी राइट एज 2πr into 2r. तो वी हैव टू डू द 4πr² ओके. तो दिस इज सरफेस एरिया ऑफ द स्फीयर वी टेक एज s1 एंड दिस इज कर्व्ड सरफेस एरिया ऑफ सिलेंडर वी टेक एज s2. नाउ इन थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन व्हाट आई फाइंड वी फाइंड द रेशियो ऑफ द एरियाज ऑब्टेन इन वन एंड सेकंड पार्ट, दैट मींस s1 अपॉन s2. दस द रिक्वायर्ड रेशियो s1 upon s2 is equal to s1 is what? 4πr² upon s2 is what? 4πr² 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 cancel to each other, so 1 upon 1, that is s2 is equal to 1:1. दिस इज द रिक्वायर्ड सोल्यूशन ऑफ द गिवन क्वेश्चन. ओके, तो डियर स्टूडेंट इन दिस वे यू कैन सॉल्व ईच एंड एवरी क्वेश्चन ऑफ योर NCERT एक्सरसाइज बेस्ड ऑन सर्फेस एरिया एंड वॉल्यूम. दिस इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन ऑफ योर NCERT एक्सरसाइज. तो डियर स्टूडेंट प्लीज डू मोर एंड मोर प्रैक्टिसेस ऑफ दैट टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन. आफ्टर दैट यू कैन सॉल्व ईच एंड एवरी क्वेश्चन ऑफ योर NCERT एक्सरसाइज बेस्ड ऑन दिस टॉपिक्स. नाउ dear friends, we take and solve some other important questions based on that topic. Let's see. Now dear friends, we take and solve some important questions of your syllabus. Let's see, this is very important question. Let's see. A cylinder and a cone are of the same radius. Are of the same radius and same height. Find the ratio of their curved surfaces. Now look, dear friend, this is also very important question here. A sphere, a cylinder, and a cone are of the same radius.
ओके आर ऑफ द सेम रेडियस ओके एंड सेम हाइट, ठीक है ओके नाउ लुक लेट द कॉमन रेडियस बी आर एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू क्वेश्चन सेम हाइट ऑल्सो द हाइट ऑफ सिलेंडर height of cylinder is equal to height of cone sphere is equal to height of sphere we take as the common radius is r तो डियर फ्रेंड यू नो दैट कि इफ यू फॉर्म अ स्फीयर एंड दिस इज यू नो दैट दिस इज आर तो टोटल हाइट ऑफ द स्फीयर इज व्हाट टोटल हाइट ऑफ द स्फीयर इज व्हाट टू आर ओके दिस इज टू आर तो इन दिस वे तो हेयर स्फीयर अ सिलेंडर एंड कोन ऑफ द सेम रेडियस एंड सेम हाइट सेम रेडियस आर तो सेम हाइट द हाइट ऑफ द स्फीयर इज आर 2R okay dear friends so here this question we take the common radius means the radius of the sphere cylinder and cone is to be what R and we take as the height of the cylinder height of the cone height of the sphere is equal to 2R now first of all we find the ratio of their curved surfaces so first of all surface area of sphere S1 you know that this is pi r square we take as the common radius is r and you know that ki the surface area of sphere is depends on only radius okay now surface area of cylinder S2 that is 2 pi r into s and we take the common height as 2r so we write as 2 pi r into 2r to the 4 pi r square 4 pi and surface area of cone that is s3 this is pi rl now first of all we find the slant height look we know that slant l square is equal to h square plus r square and h is what 2r so this is l is equal to 2 to the 4 r square plus r this is 5 r square to l is equal to under root 5 into r so here the s3 is equal to pi into r into under root 5 r to under root 5 pi r square this is the curved surface area of cone okay So in this way, first of all, we find the curved surface area of sphere, curved surface area of cylinder, curved surface area of cone. Now required ratio. Thus, the required ratio. S1 ratio, S2 ratio, S3. This is S1 is what? 4 pi square ratio 4 pi r square ratio under root 5 pi r square now we divided by pi r square so 4 ratio under root 5 4 ratio 4 under root 5 this is the required solution of the given question okay so dear students this is the method to solve that type of question so please just and do more and more practices of that type of questions after that you complete your NCERT exercise now we just want take and solve some combined types shape of solid
Okay, now we take some other important question based on this topic. Let's see. Question based on the combination of solids. We take some question based on the combination of solids. Okay, let's see. And we take a question. R2I
is in the shape of a right circular cylinder with a hemisphere on one end with a hemisphere on one end, okay, and a cone on the other, and a cone on the other. The height and radius of the cylindrical part, the height and radius of the cylindrical part are 13 centimeter and 5 centimeter. The radii of hemispherical and conical part are the same as that of the cylindrical part. Okay, find the surface area. Find the surface area of the toy. If height of the conical part is if height of the conical part is 12 centimeter. Now let's see it. Solution. Okay. Dear friends, this is one of the most important questions based on the topic surface area and volumes. Let's see. Here, a toy is in the shape of a cylinder. So, with a hemisphere on one end and a cone on the other. So, like that. That, dear friends, toy is in the form of like that, hemisphere at one end and conical above it, like that. This is the conical above it. Okay, now this, so this is the shape of the figure. Okay, the toy we take as A, B, C, D, E and F respectively, and we take as O and O dash, and from figure it is clear that the radius of the base of the cone, cylinder and hemisphere are on the same base, okay, is same. Now a toy is the shape of the cylinder with a hemisphere one end and conical end. The height and radius of the cylindrical part, height and radius of cylindrical part are 13. Height of the cylindrical portion is what? 13 centimeter. And the height and the radius of the cylinder, radius is what? 5. So this is what? 5 centimeter. So this is also 5 centimeter. Okay. Now from figure it is clear that from figure it is
clear that height of cone, height of cylinder, sorry, 13 centimeter, okay, and radius of sphere is equal to radius of cylinder is equal to radius of cone. All are equal. Radius of cone we take as r, and this is equal to 5 centimeter. And also it is given that if the toy is, if height of the conical portion, conical height of the conical part is 12. Okay, this is 12 centimeter. Now first of all we find the slant height of the cone. Okay, now from now since we know that the slant height and radius and height of the cone, this is the relation between them. So from there we first of all we find the slant height of the cone. So we get L square is equal to H is what? Height of the conical portion is 12. Radius is 5, so this is 144, this is 169, so L is equal to 169, that is 13 centimeter. So in this way dear friends, the slant height of the cone is what? 13 centimeter. Now what we find, dear friend, we find the total surface area. Now we find the surface area, find the surface area of the toy. We find the surface area of the toy. So surface area of the toy is CSA of hemisphere, CSA of cylinder, and CSA of cone. Okay, so we using that concept. Now look, thus from figure, it is clear that surface area of the toy is equal to surface area of the toy is what curved surface area of cylindrical part plus curved surface area of hemispherical part plus curved surface area of conical part. Now we apply the formula of each and every solids like that. Let's see, curved surface area of cylindrical is what? 2 pi r h plus curved surface area of hemisphere 2 pi r square, and curved surface area of conical part pi r l. We take as r because of the radius of the cone, cylinder and hemisphere all are same. Now we take pi as common, we take pi r as common. So this is 2h plus pi r, this is 2r, okay, plus l. Now 2h plus 2r plus l. Now dear friend, what I do now, we put the each and every values in that formula. Let's see, now we put the each and every put the values of now we put the values of R, H and L respectively we get. Let's see, this is surface area of the wire, no? That is surface area of the wire. This is pi, the value of pi is 22 upon 7, R is what, 5 into 2H. This is the height of the cylindrical portion, this is which is what, 13, so 2 into 13 plus 2R, and 2 radius is 5, L slant height of the cone which we find as 13. Now we simplify there. This is 110 upon 7 into this is 26, 10, 13. Okay, now we simplify them. Forty-nine. This is 49. Now 7 7 are 49. Now 700, 777, 770 centimeter square because of surface area of the solid always is in square unit. So 770 centimeter square. This is the required solution of the given question. Okay, so dear friend, this is a very important question. Based on the topic combination of solid. So please, dear student, do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on the topic surface area and volumes. Because of these are the very important questions which we discuss in that class and also in previous classes. Okay, dear students. Now, look once more time. This is the toy which is given in our question and says that a toy is in the form of cylinder, one end at hemispherical end and other is but conical end, and the height of the cylindrical ends is given as 13. From figure it is clear that the radius of the conical portion, cylindrical portion and hemispherical portion all are equal because all are on the same base. Okay, now so we know that surface area of toy means what? Curved surface area of hemisphere, curved surface area of cylinder plus curved surface area of cone. So for curved surface area of cone, first of all we find the slant height because of the height and radius of the base already in given in conical portion. So we know that the square of slant height is equal to the sum of the square of height and radius of the base. So in this way we find the slant height of the cone, which is find as 13. After that we apply the concept, the surface area of the toy is curved surface area of cylindrical part, curved surface area of hemispherical part and curved surface area of conical part. Now we put the formula of each and every shapes of solids which are involved in that figure. So now 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square plus pi r l. Now we take pi r as common to 2 h plus 2 r plus l. Now we put all the values as l r h r and L in that expressions, that formula, and we simplify them, and after simplification like that we take pi r as common because R is same for all the solid which is involved in that chapter, and now we putting all the value and hence we find its result. Okay, dear students, which is 770 centimeters square. This is the required surface area of the toy. Thus, dear students, in this way, in today's class, we take and solve some important questions related to the topic surface area and volumes, and we simplify them. Now, first of all, you revise all the important questions, which all the questions which we discuss in that class, and always in all and also in previous classes, and do more and more practices of that type of questions. Now, in next class, we take and solve some other important questions related to that chapter. Okay, now thanks to all.